today I'm going to present some of the artworks that I made from the Star Wars corpus.
So this was Dr. Kirell Benzi's stunning artwork entitled Dark Side and the Light. Kirell recently graduated with a PhD from EPFL, and his depiction of the Star Wars universe was featured on the EPFL news website, as well as Engadget, Gizmodo, and many other places on the web. Although I'm pretty sure that his crowning achievement is to be featured on Zettawides. Maybe. In any case, Kirell has made a lot of stunning data visualizations of many data structures.
So here, what we have is it's a network, a graph. So what is a graph? A graph is just a mathematical, representation or tool to represent objects and the relationships between objects. So a graph is composed of two main components. First, we have the nodes. So it's what you see here, all the small dots. And the second part is the edges. And the edges are just the links between the two nodes.
Because of their simplicity, graphs, also known as networks, are really ubiquitous in the way we think and model the world around us. Examples of graphs include the internet, social networks, the web, electrical grids, neural networks, Google's graph knowledge, road networks, and so on and so on. They are really ubiquitous. And usually, they are also pretty huge.
In this network, we have almost 20,000 characters.
Wait, what? I watched the Star Wars movies and I'm pretty sure there were not 20,000 characters.
If you just think about the movies, you would have like more or less 200 characters. Here it's 20,000. And the number of links is around 70,000.
But where do all of these characters come from?
It's in the extended universe. And the extended Star Wars universe is about all the books, the movies, the video games, anything that has been written or said or shot around Star Wars.
Okay, so there are books written on Star Wars?
I think there are more like 850 short stories and books written around Star Wars. And the number of video games is huge. I don't know, more than 50 probably. So yeah, it's a lot of content.
Wait, how can you gather data from so many different contents on so many different supports?
So there's a Star Wars wiki called Wikipedia. I think you have now should be more than 135,000 pages created by humans. So it's like people are going there, editing pages, changing the biography, creating links between all this content. So it's really huge. Okay, Wikipedia is 6 million, of course, but Wikipedia is on real life, right? Here it's only on Star Wars, so it's quite big, actually.
Okay, I'll admit it. I'm nowhere near enough of a Star Wars fan to be even aware of all the madness surrounding this huge universe. The Star Wars universe is absolutely huge, and I'm going to guess that only a handful of hardcore Star Wars fans among you are aware of just how huge this universe is.
The timeline is, as I was saying earlier, spent over 37,000 years. But actually, it's not equal. I mean, you have more books or more storyline that have been written in the original trilogy. And also a lot of video games, one big video game in like 3,000 years before the trilogy. So it's really huge.
It's really exploring the vastness of a universe in all dimensions, both in space and in time. And as you can guess, simply collecting all of the data about all of the characters of the Star Wars expanded universe is already quite tricky. But of course, what makes the data analysis so cool is to make artwork out of the data.
The idea was to actually fetch all the characters, the biography of each character, and to try to connect different characters if they co-appear in the biography.
QL then created a dot for each character and drew a line between character A and B if B appears in character A's biography. More generally, the graph between the characters is called a social network, and the social network between the characters of Star Wars gives us another reading of the Star Wars universe. In fact, I'm always intrigued by the way story writers structure the social networks between their main characters. If you watch TV shows, I suggest you ponder this. Every now and then, the writers will search for a good excuse to bring together two main characters that have hardly interacted before. This is because it's often very interesting to have a highly connected social network between the main characters. In the case of Star Wars, this has definitely been the case between Princess Leia, Luke Skywalker, and Darth Vader. At first, it seemed like these three main characters were hardly connected at all. But as it turned out... Wait, was I on the brink of spoiling you? You do know what the interactions between these three main characters is, don't you? In any case, it might be a good idea for story writers to draw social networks of their main characters every now and then, and to see what missing links could be created. But of course, not every link makes sense. In the case of the Star Wars Expanded Universe, there's a very good reason why the social network cannot be entirely well connected.
The timeline of Star Wars spans across 37,000 years. Of course, you would have different communities corresponding roughly to the different eras. What you would have in the center is the most famous characters. For instance, here you would have the Emperor, so the Palpatine. Here you would have Luke Skywalker in this blue Yoda and all the famous characters. Of course, you only know roughly 20 characters, but imagine this point here is also another character that maybe you have never heard of because it's in this obscure video game, released 20 years ago. But still, it is one of the, still belongs in the Star Wars corpus.
Now, of course, in the Star Wars universe, there are two particularly important communities.
For the cause here, the idea was to, show the raging conflict in the galaxy between good and evil. So, of course, in blue, you will have all the good guys, the light side of the Force, and in red, the Sith, the Empire, the bad guys. And you can, as you can notice, you also have like a yellow nodes. There are some green nodes also, but yellow nodes. And the yellow nodes are actually representing the criminals. Because actually, in the Star Wars universe, there are lots of criminals, many criminals. And they are, of course, as you would expect, mostly connected to the bad guys. So this is this. Here you have Jabba the Hutt. And I think you have somewhere here you have Jango Fett and Boba Fett, two bounty hunters, if you're familiar with the Star Wars universe.
Finally, one last thing that might be missing from Kirell's static depiction of the Star Wars universe is that the universe is actually dynamic, not in the sense that the characters are evolving through time, but what we learn from the characters is evolving.
If anything happens around the Star Wars universe, could be a new movie, of course, a new video game, a new book, a new merchandising, whatever, people are starting to edit the page, changing their story or changing accordingly to the what has just been released. So yeah, it's always being edited by people. It's really dynamic.
And in the end, it's probably this dynamic aspect that brightens even more our amazement when discovering the Star Wars universe. For instance, this link that suddenly appeared between Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader forced us to rethink the entire social network of the Star Wars universe. I think there's a wonderful poetry that's underlying Kirell's work, and its visual representation is both beautiful and insightful. It has literally given me a new way to see the Star Wars universe.
According to Star Wars lore, lightsabers may look like laser weapons, but are in fact plasma-based.
All the paths leads to Martin Vetterli, which is actually the president of EPFL. It's really funny because you could say, now, yes, the president of EPFL has been elected by, because it connects most of the people of the network.